Hi everyone, welcome back to Sid's Killer Reviews, where this week we're reviewing John Wick 4, starring Keanu Reeves. What was your overall impression of the movie?
I liked it.
What would you give it on a scale of 1 to 10?
8.5 out of 10.
Okay.
What did you think? What would you give it?
It was amazing. John Wick's are my favorite, so... I think because he died, I'll give it a 9.5.
Spoiler alert.
Yeah. I'd like to believe he didn't die, though. What do you think the movie did really well?
I mean, it does a lot of the action scenes, and the choreography was amazing. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like,
yeah.
I really liked this time how they, like, used bows. I really liked
yeah.
some of that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, that was really funny.
Yeah. Like, Akira. The Osaka concierge, she was badass. Like, she was so cool with her, like, bow whipping him, and then she did, like, the pullback right in that guy's head.
Yeah.
Like,
it reminded me a lot of Lord of the Rings. There was a better, I think this one was better than the third one, because there was definitely a bad guy.
Yeah. You hate Marquis. Like, you really hate Marquis.
What didn't you like about it?
Obviously, I didn't like the ending a little bit. I like happy endings, so I guess it was happy because if he truly did die, you know, like he says Helen before he dies, he was thinking of his wife, so I'd like to believe he's with her, but, like, obviously I want more movies, so I don't want him to die, but I guess that's what I didn't like. Also, I had mentioned to you before, I don't like that John Wick puts so much detail into making it pretty realistic for an assassin. Like, he's vulnerable and all that stuff.
Kind of, but yeah.
They usually do a pretty good job at that, but I think with this one, like in the last one, we see the development of the Teflon suits and stuff, but this one, it was just completely overkilled and unrealistic that if you get shot, you're still gonna feel it kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, they keep getting shot on their arms and stuff, and it doesn't even affect them. Like, they can just keep walking. Like, that would definitely, like, put your shoulder back. That would definitely bruise. It would hurt, you know?
Yeah.
And they, like, walk through it like it's nothing.
Yeah. Like, so. He takes a shotgun blast
yeah,
at the jacket,
in the
and
church,
it just knocks
yeah.
him down.
Yeah.
But, like, as much as it knocked him down, it probably breaks some bones and stuff.
Yeah,
yeah,
definitely. And, like, all of the Marquee guys... Like, when they invade Osaka and they're all shooting them, or, like, he blocks an arrow, like, it's
yeah.
still gonna hurt. You know what I mean? Like, the momentum of the bullet just can't stop completely, you know? It's still fabric, it still has some give, obviously, because they're moving, you know? So, I think that was the hardest thing for me watching that, is just, like, knowing how that's not even realistic at all.
So that kind of bleeds into what I didn't like about the movie, is I felt like there was too much killing.
Mm-hmm.
So I think they had to do that in order to make a bunch of different ways to kill people.
Yeah.
Because they had to make the gunfights longer, and they had to have more armor on people.
Yeah.
So they had to make them just as uninvincible as
John
Wick is.
Harder to kill. Yeah, harder to
And so
kill.
I felt like there was way more quantity than quality. That's one of the big problems I had with the movie.
Yeah. I still think they were quality because I think they brought a lot of different killing abilities from John Wick. Like, we see a lot of hand-to-hand combat in this movie especially, but, like, there's different methods that he does. Like, he whips out the nunchucks, and, like, that's hilarious to me. It was really funny, but he was really good, and there was memorable different killing methods, you know? Like, they kind of did, like, Western with the revolvers, and then there was the dragon breath shotgun, in the overhead scene, which was really cool. I actually really liked the overhead scene.
Yeah, that was my favorite scene.
Yeah, that was really well done.
I guess I missed the stuff, like, in the first one when he's killing the guy with the knife. It takes a while. And it's, like, a slow scene.
Which guy?
It's when his house gets invaded and he's got, like, he's hitting it with
oh,
his hand.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Like, I liked that because that, it's unique, but it also took a while.
Mm-hmm.
I don't feel like anything took a while on this one, even though there's unique kills, they all went by so fast.
Kind of. There were some that definitely took a while.
It took a while to kill the guy, but not like the actual killing. I also didn't really like the Marquee character.
I did. I thought it was executed very well. I think they wrote the character very well. And I think they picked the perfect person to portray him. Like
he was I get it. He was supposed to be that guy. I wasn't afraid of him. I wasn't afraid for John Wick, of the Marquis.
No, I wasn't either. That's not why you don't like him, though. You know. That's
no,
why
I get that. I'm just saying he wasn't that. Like it was. It wasn't a good character for me, just because it wasn't super scary.
He's just scary because he's obviously insane.
Like, I feel like he wouldn't have been powerful if, like, he didn't have all of his bodyguards. He's not scary without all the supporting characters.
Yeah, and that's kind of why I really wish that he did the duel. Like, I the first time I saw this twice. The first time I saw it. The first time I saw it, first of all, I really sympathize with Kane, too. I feel bad, and this movie makes me, like, my heart ache because it's basically friends killing each other. Like, none of them want to kill each other.
Yeah, that
but
was
they
bad.
Have to. Yeah. And so I really didn't like that they made Kane do it. I mean, it was good how they did it. It was a good development, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I think it's better than if it was just Marquis and he just killed the Marquis that way, you know? I think it was definitely more rewarding to see them shoot each other and be like, nice shot, and they were still like goofing around until they died. And then,
like, I think that's another thing I didn't like, because they didn't bring a lot of the John Wick lore into this one as much as they could have. Like, why didn't Kane have a marker on? You kind of find little bits and pieces, but there's not a real good explanation why Kane's has to be in service of the High Table again.
Yeah, the High Table aspect is complicated. I don't think anything is concrete with the High Table, as you see in the movies.
Yeah.
You know, everything's so messed up, and then like the different people that sit at the table do things differently, and there's all these rules and stuff, so that's probably just one of the rules, is that he said he'd be of service. So, you know, I mean, they kind of talk about it a little bit, like when they go to Koji and Kane is like, you don't owe him anything, you don't have a marker.
Yeah.
He said that. So, but I like the brotherhood thing, how they like, they value how close they are, and how Koji, like, invites him into his hotel and then lets him go away. He probably knew he was gonna die by doing that, so. And how Kane helps him up the stairs. That was just nice.
Well, he has to.
Yeah.
So.
But he was nice about it, you know.
So what was your favorite scene?
Favorite funny scene? Obviously, the stairs rolling was hilarious. The whole movie theater was cackling, like.
It's ridiculous, yes.
People
it
in front
fun.
Of me said, grab hold of something! It was very... I feel like Keanu has to put that in there, like, as a comedic relief of a very serious scene, you know?
Yeah.
And, like, the tension's building, and then... I was down all 222 stairs, so...
Yeah.
That was hilarious. My favorite action scene? There's just so many good ones. I really liked the nunchucks. Like, I like the whole Osaka choreography and stuff. Like, I loved, like you said, the bows. I really liked him with the glass, and then him with Kane, and are you dead, John? I think Kane was amazing, too, because the Donnie Lee, the actor that played him, did such a well job playing blind. That, like, when he shoots, he's not looking where he's shooting, and all of that stuff, like, it had to have taken crazy amounts of practice to make that look believable, you know what I mean? And then it was smart to have the doorbell sensor so he could tell where people were when they walked through.
Yeah, I was bummed he only used it once.
I know, I thought he was going to use some more, but what was your favorite scene?
I really liked the overhead scene.
Yeah.
And the abandoned building, the way that was filmed was amazing.
Yeah.
And I liked how they just, I don't know, looked so smooth.
Yeah.
Going from, like, one to the other, to the other,
it
to the other.
It looked like one take, yeah.
It did look like one take. I don't know if it was.
Probably not. There's no way.
Yeah, I don't think they could have done it one take either.
Yeah.
And my other favorite scene, I think, is when they're around the Arc de Triomphe.
Yes! Oh my gosh, I forgot about that. Yeah, I loved the car sequence. I thought it was so cool. That he did all those stunts, you know? Like
I didn't.
He did all that driving himself.
Oh, okay.
Like, that's not fake, that's real, you know? And so, like, he did all the turns and the driving backwards, and that's just so cool in real life, but then you're doing that while killing people? That's awesome.
Yeah. I just liked all the cars going by, and it just added more element to, like, making it exciting.
Yeah.
You know?
Mm-hmm. It's just, it's another, I think, on top of, like, the Teflon suit things, is that that scene in particular, or all these scenes in public, it kind of has me asking more questions on, like, how underground is the Assassin Society in here? Because nobody, like, stopped and was like, oh my god! Or
yeah.
All the people's cars that got ruined weren't, like, freaking out or running away. Like, you don't see civilians panicking. And then there's, like, a whole radio channel. And it's pretty yeah. clear, like, that there's a hit on somebody, you know? So it's like, just how underground is the assassin?
I mean, it's world? Not. I think in the second movie, you kind of learn that when everybody, like, the phones start going off and yeah. there's like half the crowd's phone yeah. goes off to hunt John Wick. So,
right.
I don't think it's as underground in the John Wick world as.
Yeah.
I think it is in the first one, but I think they kind of give that up in the second. No.
That's just something I wish was, like, answered or maybe talked about a little bit more. I really liked all the music as well. Like, the John Wick usually has, like, really good bass and good music, you know, that you could feel it. And it gets you excited just from the music itself. Like, oh, this is going to be a good scene. You know when the music, like, picks up. I really like the music. And then, like, there's always the lighting, too. Like, John Wick always has a club scene.
Yep.
So when he killed that fat guy, it was, like, the notorious John Wick club scene. And then he just goes through people that are dancing with a gun. And, like, there was a few people that turned their head and looked concerned. And then they just go back to dancing.
I mean, they all start to running at the end of that scene. I can't remember yeah. what happens, but everyone leaves.
Yeah.
Screaming.
Yeah. I really liked the Scott Adkins plays the guy with the gold teeth, the fat guy. And I really liked his character. I think he did a good job with that. And then I loved that they show you that John Wick can use anything in any situation because he just takes the card and slices his neck. You
yeah,
know what I mean? Like, that's just
card.
Awesome that they show that he thinks about everything. Wherever he is, he could kill you with a card, a pencil, you know, like.
Yeah, I liked that.
Yeah, I loved his face when he died, too.
Yeah, that's funny.
Yeah, it was like that cheesy smile. Like,
out of all the characters, I liked him the least.
Yeah. Well, I don't think you're supposed to like him.
No, I just meant like, even, I didn't think it really needed to be in the movie. Mm. I didn't like him as a character. But that's just me. I did. Yeah, I don't have a good reason why either, honestly. I don't know why. I think I just like,
I liked it too because it, like John tells Kane when he's there, this is personal. So, don't kill me because this is something I need to do for personal because he killed his uncle.
Yeah.
So I like that it's not just killing people just to be free again. This is personal. Like,
I mean, it's not his real uncle.
No, but
he's
still.
He's an orphan, but.
Still, though, you know, like that's his
the head of
family,
that family
he had,
yeah.
Yeah. And I like that they welcome him back in, you know, that girl was cool. Marquis had some really cool suits, like.
His clothes.
Sparkly, yeah.
Yeah.
He had good clothes, yeah. Winston was really funny in this one, like all of his little snippets. Basically, checkmate when he went to deliver the duel
yeah.
thing,
yeah.
and he leaves it on the couch and he like pets it.
I'll leave when I'm done.
Yeah. He turns to him and says, I'm done, and yeah. walks away. The last 10 paces that they go in, John Wick doesn't shoot. And so the Marquis gets all excited, like, oh, I'm going to kill John Wick. I get to do it. And he goes over. And then Winston says, you arrogant asshole. He didn't shoot. And so it was a very rewarding death. Like, it wasn't just they lost, so then Wick just shot him. You know, it was like he died because he's an idiot, you know.
Out of the four, where would you replace this one? Like,
oh,
what's your favorite John Wick?
Because
mine is definitely the first one. And then the second one, and then I would do the fourth one, and then the third one.
Honestly, I'd say this one is tied with the first one. It's difficult. I think stylistically, and like how it was filmed, and the choreography, this is number one. But then the first one, I liked the purpose more of that they took everything that he had left, basically. And that it was more revenge-based than.
Yeah.
The past couple of movies have just been, like, the second one, that was dumb. Like, his decision was really dumb, you know? So you're kind of like, well, this is what you get. Like, that's your consequence for doing that.
Yep.
Because that's the whole thing they preach is consequences. So that's, like, what that is. But the first one is like, no, they deserve that, you know?
I like the dialogue in the first one the best.
Yeah.
Like, even at the end, when the bad guy I'll be seeing your job.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be seeing you. Like, that's how it ends.
Yeah.
Well, that's what they say to each other.
John, let's talk. What did he say? Enough. Yeah. There was a lot of, like, in the first one, how they call him the boogeyman, he just seems, like, more intimidating. And then I think as it goes on, like, people are still intimidated by him, but the fact that people still try kind of makes you feel like they don't think he's as scary as he is, you know? But in the first one, like, you mention the Baba Yaga or boogeyman, and they're like, oh my god, you're gonna die. I think I kind of like that more.
Yeah, I like that a lot more.
He's not the boogeyman. He's the man you send to kill the fucking boogeyman, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it felt like they kind of lose that as the movies go on.
Yeah. I mean, they're still all great. Like, they're still really
cool. Oh, yeah, and definitely. They have
aspects that are so awesome. Not all of them, but... In the second one, after he gets sent to kill the Italian girl, and then her, like, boyfriend or whatever goes after John Wick.
Her bodyguard, yeah.
And they're, like, shooting through the train station.
Yes. Yeah. I love that.
They did that at the Arc de Triomphe through the cars. They're, like, waiting for the cars to pass, and they're shooting at each other. Yeah. So they kind of, like, reference their own movies and stuff, which is funny. Keanu is hot. I liked that in every movie there's a dog, too, and that you see that his dog's being cared for by the king. And so that's nice. You know, that dog's getting treated well. And then Mr. Nobody's dog. Yeah. He's on the guy that hit her. I just love that. That's just so awesome. Well, and you think, like, when she gets hit, too, you're like, oh, no, not another one. We can't. Yeah. Like, we gotta stop killing dogs. And she got back up. Yes. I cried both times.
It was sadder than some of the other ones, you know. Not as sad as the first one to me, but still pretty sad.
Yeah.
Definitely sadder than 2 and 3. I was upset when the concierge died.
Yeah.
Like, well, I was unprepared.
Well,
and
then
he
died in real life, too, so recently. That was like, oh.
Oh my god, I can't see anything.